So I'm a big advocate of a better use of data within board reporting, and we're really trying to push from NHS improvement the use of what we're describing as measurement for improvement within the NHS. However, it's probably a bit of a misnomer from my perspective, because whilst it is a really important tool to use in improvement activity, for me it could equally be described as measurement for better judgment. And having sat on NHS boards for a number of years and also been responsible for preparing board reports and papers, it just struck me a number of years ago now how the use of particularly RAG rating with single points of data really underplays the importance of debate at board level. So to give a couple of practical examples, it's very easy to sit in a board meeting and look at performance against a national target, such as A&E. And it can be green and shown over a time period even as green, green, green. But if you look at the numbers behind the data, that might see something that was well above the national standard and increasingly deteriorating over a period of time. But there's a risk we fall into the trap of only actually looking at it, understanding or doing something about it when it suddenly switches to red. So it's really important to really understand a better context. And similarly, you can be in a position where, as a national body, we react to a RAG rating. So an organisation that might be performing against a national target marginally 1 month and marginally failing the next can provoke a very different reaction at a national level in terms of praise for achievement or requesting for action plans, when actually if you look at the data over time and in looking at it as a process and whether it's in control, there might be no statistical difference between that performance, and yet we respond in a different way. And I've seen that behaviour then translate to local board levels, where non-executives will pull apart the data and performance for something that actually really doesn't merit that level of scrutiny, certainly if it's already been debated in a prior month. So the importance of understanding whether processes are in control is really important. And a lot of this work kind of post-war from the states where much of this thinking really emanated wasn't in a sense of quality improvement as we perhaps have known it. Really much about kind of hard industrial operations, and a good business understands its processes, what's in control, have the interventions been made to try and secure improvement actually achieved anything. So really powerful tools. I'm also aware though that the use of this can go down a bit of a rabbit hole into technical detail around how do you calculate the control limits. And that's not really where we see the vast majority of people's knowledge having to be. Yes, we want to create centres of excellence, a knowledge base within the analyst community to really understand this. But we want to make the tools available that can give a local decision makers, local managers, leaders, the confidence to see from the data in front of them whether what they're trying to achieve is being achieved. And when performance moves, is it at a level that you really need to understand, or is it just part of natural variation? I'm really pleased to hear variation being spoken about more and more in the NHS, but crucially being described about the unwarranted variation. So really understanding where the natural variation of a process is fine, it's a fact of life, you need to work with that, you need to plan for that, but when there's unwarranted variation, when you've got outlying data, then really use it to investigate, not to jump to initial judgments, but really understand the reasons and to see if things can be done about it. So my pledge is to encourage the use of SPC and other good analytics at board level. It's a privilege I have to work in a national role that I get to talk to boards across the country, and really want to use that opportunity to encourage a better use of data to inform good decision making and enable improvement.